What is love? What do you think this thing is? Like our attachment to other human beings. And is it something that we should give to just a few people?
Yes, that's for sure. When I was working with D.L. Hughley in his book, he didn't use the term, but he was describing like low-key depression. And he talked about how he was in the airport and he noticed a girl had a red dress and he went up and thanked her. And she was like, what are you thanking for? And he had realized he hadn't registered color in like weeks. And I think love is like that. When you see someone and you just like, oh, like your eyes are open. Like this is something I've never seen before. Or I want more of this, that kind of thing. It's really, it really disorients and reorients your thinking.
Don't you find that like the world is full of that, like nonstop? It's not just like a person either. It's like,
but yes. But when it's in a person, it's a whole other level because it's like I could have this is going to be great for years. It's like you know, every day it's something new. I mean that is rare.
You think it's rare?
I mean, find someone who you could talk to them for years and not run out of things to talk to.
Oh, that's true, for years, yes.
Yeah, that's rare. And know that they really, if you leave the room, they will do right by you. That's really rare.
Well, from a Russian perspective, you just don't give them another choice. For, this is Tavarish New Year, New Year's Eve. So you talked about secession and the world burning down and you holding the match at the end,
yes,
standing with a big smile on your face.
Yes. Why so serious?
But, let me ask you, if it doesn't include flame and secession and destruction and a laughing malice and makeup and a white suit at the end, how do we bring more kindness and love to the world in 2021?
Oh, easy. Be comfortable saying, I want to be happy. And if there's someone who interjects and gives you attitude, arm's length them. Surround yourself with people who also want to be happy. Here's a great example. My buddy, Chris Williamson, who I mentioned before, he's a podcaster, does Modern Wisdom. He's an awesome dude, and we became very close friends this past year. And he was in Dubai recently, and he sent me pics from Dubai by the pool, just loving life. And it took me a week, and then it clicked in my head. And I'm like, you know what? For some other people, if they saw him, underwear model, at the pool, they would think this is him bragging or humble bragging. And that never entered my head. I'm like, oh man, I'm so glad my boy can be having a good time and is sharing his joy with me. That's the kind of people you need to surround yourself with, where it never enters their head to be resentful or anything other than sharing in your bounty.
What makes you happy?
I'm happy all the time. And one of the points I made in my life is like, I really did not like to give advice because I feel don't give advice until you know what you're talking about. And to me, what makes me happy is being self-actualized. I am in a position with my career where I could be myself 24/7, where I never have to engage in small talk, where I never have to interact with someone I don't want to. And I'm very blessed to have that. Very few people have that. And to have that be not only, to have that be like rewarded and having people find that something of value to them makes me very, very happy. But also being an uncle, you know, I have two little nephews. They make me very, very happy. Sure, my sister's raising them Russian, so they talk like immigrants, but that's okay. We're going to change that. We have to dismember her. That's fine. That makes me happy. And like to be able to finish this book and know it's going to give people a sense of hope, that's really validating.
Well, what are you most grateful for? For our conversation today.
You're stealing my bit. What am I most grateful for? I am very grateful that I can come in here not knowing what we're going to talk about and know it's not going to be something I have to be on guard about or I have to watch my words. and that neither you or your audience is going to be responding derisively. I feel safe here.
You're welcome.
Bye, Steve.
Thanks for talking to me, Michael. It was awesome.